Hello students, in continuity of chapter 7, today we are going to study about animal earthworm in detail. Here, in this animal, actually we are going to study about its morphology, it means external features, as well as its anatomy, it means that various system and organization in body of this animal. Earthworm is a reddish brown terrestrial invertebrate that inhabits the upper layer of moist soil. All of you have seen this animal. Actually, its habitat is soil, and during monsoon season easily it is observable. During daytime they live in burrows made by boring and swelling the soil. In gardens they can be traced by their racial deposits known as worm casting. In this figure we can clearly observe about external structure features, or we can say morphology of earthworm. It suggests the organization of body in earthworm. Left hand side figure, that is dorsal view. Right hand side figure, it is about ventral view of this animal. And the figure in between this, it is actually lateral view showing mouth opening. In dorsal view of earthworm body, you can see the both side opening on anterior side of body, that is prostomium, it means that opening of mouth, and last segment, that is opening as a anus. In between this structure, clitellum is observed. It's a dark ring like structure. On right hand side, that is ventral view of this animal earthworm. In ventral view of body of earthworm, some more structures are clearly observed by studying its external feature. It is like locomotory organ, seta of setae, opening of that genital pore as a male and female. Openings are there, genital papillae, grooves in the body of earthworm, as well as its mouth and anus opening is there. So this way we can compare dorsal body view of earthworm and ventral body view of earthworm by studying this figure. Next one is lateral view showing mouth opening. Here it's actually sectional view of mouth area of earthworm. The first segment has an opening of mouth, that is known as prostemium. You can see here easily, that is opening of mouth. And ring structure is observed, body is segmented. So ring of seta or setae is there. Segmental body organization, that is metamius, you can study here. So by studying this figure, now we have clear idea about body of earthworm, its dorsal view, ventral view, and lateral view showing mouth opening. Earthworm body is reddish brown color, and it's a terrestrial invertebrate organism animal which lives in upper layer of moist soil. Generally common Indian earthworms, they are of Ferritima and Imbricus type of earthworm. Their body is long cylindrical body and divided into many segments. These segments are, their organization is similar, so they are known as metamius, and about it is 100 to 120 in number. Their ventral body surface, it contain genital pore, and dorsal surface which contain mid dorsal line. By studying the dorsal view and ventral view, we can easily study this structure also on the body of earthworm. Body is divided into approximately 100 to 120 number of segment. First body segment of earthworm body is known as peristomium, which contain mouth, or we can also say it's a one type of porous type of opening of mouth. So anterior end of body, it consists of mouth and the prostomium. 14 to 16 segments, they are covered by dark band called clitellum. So, in the body of earthworm, segment number 14, 15, 16 is a one type of dark band like structure, and it is known as clitellum. We can clearly observe this structure on the body of earthworm. If you talk about genital pore, its opening on the body surface of earthworm, single genital pore is present on mid-ventral line of 14 segment. One pair of male genital pore is present on 18 segment on ventrolateral side of body. So this way, this type of opening as a genital pore is there, which is useful at the time of fertilization. All the segment except first, last and clitellum, it means that first segment, last segment and segment number 14, 15, 16, other segments, they contain S-shaped ceta for locomotion. It is small hairy structure located on these segments and known as ceta. It is useful for locomotion purpose in earthworm. Alimentary canal in the body of earthworm, that is straight tubular structure, and it begins from segment number 1 and it extends up to last segment. In this alimentary canal organization, various parts are observed. They are part of this system. They are buccal cavity, muscular pharynx, esophagus that leads to gizzard, and it is helpful in grinding the soil particle and decaying leaves. In this structure, stomach and small intestine leads to anus. Segment number 26 to 35, between 26 to 35 segment, the intestine has an internal median fold and it is known as typhlosol. This area, this region, typhlosol, this increase the effective area of absorption in intestine region. So, it is useful for digestion purpose in the body of earthworm. In the body of earthworm, its circulatory system is closed type of muscular system. It consists of heart, blood vessel and capillaries. Actually, it is not typical heart structure, but heart-like structure is there. So, we can say this closed circulatory system is made up of heart, blood vessel and capillaries in the body of earthworm. Here, blood glands are present on the 4th, 5th and 6th segments. The main role of this blood gland, their function is to produce blood cells and hemoglobin. Here in the body of earthworm, this hemoglobin, it is dissolved in blood plasma. If you talk about respiratory system in the body of earthworm, it collects respiratory organs and respires through moist skin. So here skin is very important for purpose of respiration. Excretory system in the body of earthworm, it is made up of units known as nephridia. This excretory organ is coiled segmental tubular structure and it is known as nephridia. Nephridia, they are of three types in the body of earthworm, and it is named the behalf of either presence or location in particular area in their body. They are septal nephridia, integumentary nephridia and pharyngeal nephridia. Nerve system in the body of earthworm, basically it is represented by ganglia. We can easily understand that this ganglia means a neuron or nerve cell like structure. It is arranged segment wise on the ventral pair nerve cord. The body of earthworm, it does not show typical nerve system like structure like higher organism. It means it's not made up of brain and spinal cord, but this function is carried out by this ganglia or group of nerve cell. Nerve cord in the anterior region, it means third and fourth segment, it bifurcates and join the central ganglia dorsally to form a nerve ring. So by this organization, it form a ring like structure present in nerve system in the body of earthworm, and this ring like structure is known as nerve ring. Actually, it's a function we can compare with brain also. Earthworm, this animal is hermaphrodite. It means that bisexual animal having both male and female reproductive system. In male reproductive system, they are having main one pair of testes. Its location, it is present in 10th and 11th segment. So male reproductive system is present testes, one pair of testes in 10th and 11th segment. Some accessory reproductive glands are there. They are prostate and spermatic duct, which open to surface as male genital pore on 18th segment. This type of opening as a male genital pore, it is actually useful at the time of fertilization in the body of earthworm. If we talk about female reproductive system in the body of earthworm, it is made up of one pair of ovaries. These ovaries, they are attached to the intersegmental septum of segment number 12 and 13. Same way like male opening, genital pore opening, here in female genital pore open on ventral side of 14th segment. So if we compare both system, male reproductive system and female reproductive system, in male system one pair of testes, in female one pair of ovaries. These testes, they are located in segment number 10th and 11th. So ovary, they are located segment number 12 and 13. Male genital pore open outside on 18th number segment, but female genital pore, it opens outside on 14th number of segment. So this way, in the body of earthworm, a well developed reproductive system is observed. Mutual exchange of sperms take place during mating in the body of earthworm. So this way, each and every system in the body of earthworm, it means it is like alimentary canal, circulatory system, nerve system and reproductive system, they are well organized in the body of this animal. After fertilization process, mature sperms and egg cells along with nutritive materials, they are deposited in cocoon in the soil where fertilization takes place. This cocoon is a special feature of this animal. Actually, when mature sperms and egg cells along with their nutritive material, they are deposited, this structure is known as cocoon structure. Earthworms, they are also known as friends of farmer because they make burrows in the soil and make it porous, which help in respiration and penetration of the developing plant roots. So it is very useful for farmers. The process of increasing fertility of soil by earthworm is called vermicomposting. So this way, this soil fertility is increased by activity of this animal present in field, and it is known as vermicomposting. They are also used as bait in game fishing. So this way, this earthworm animal is also very useful to mankind. Now let's study a closed circulatory system in the body of earthworm. Now as you know very well, it is made up of blood vessels, capillary and heart. As you can see in this figure also, ventral surface organization and dorsal surface organization in the body of earthworm as a part of circulatory system. In here, contraction keep blood circulating in one direction. Smaller blood vessels supply the gut, nerve cord and the body wall. Blood glands are present. Now as you know very well, in the segment number 4, 5, 6 segment, they produce blood cell and hemoglobin which is dissolved in blood plasma. These blood cells are phagocytic in their nature. So in this figure we can study the organization of circulatory system. The unit of heart, heart chambers, you can easily observe here. The circulation blood, its direction is also mentioned in this figure. So dorsal vessel, lateral hearts, lateral esophageal hearts, then subneural vessels, anterior loops, ventral vessels and lateral esophageal vessels, they are observed in this figure. So this way we can come to know about the organization of closed type of circulatory system in the body of earthworm, which is made up of blood cell, blood vessels, capillaries and heart. Now, elementary canal of earthworm. The elementary canal is straight tube-like structure and it runs between first to last segment in the body of earthworm. Here you can see the opening on the first segment, that is opening as a mouth in the body of earthworm. A terminal mouth opens into buccal cavity. It is located segment number in internal structure of elementary canal in the body of earthworm. So terminal mouth opens into buccal cavity, that is 1 to 3 segment. It means that segment number 1 to 3, which leads into muscular pharynx. The structural organization easily we can study in this figure also. A small narrow tube, esophagus. It is located in between segment number 5, 6 and 7. It continues into a muscular gizzard which is located in segment number 8 and 9. We can study here also this gizzard structure. If we talk about function of this gizzard, it helps in grinding the soil particles, because the main food for earthworm, that is soil particle and decaying leaves. Stomach extends from segment number 9 to 14 here. Clearly we can study segment of this stomach also in between 9 to 14 number segment. The food of the earthworm is decaying leaves and organic matter mixed with soil. Calciferous glands present in the stomach which neutralize the humic acid present in humus. It is very important for digestive system in the body of earthworm. Intestine here starts from the segment number 15th. So from 15th segment onwards and it continues till the last segment of the body. So exact location of intestine in the body of earthworm, that is from segment number 15th to last segment of its body. A pair of short and conical intestinal cecae project from the intestine on the segment number 26. So intestinal cecae are located this way here, the segment number 26. The characteristic feature of the intestine after segment number 26 segment, except the last 23 to 25 segment, is the presence of internal median fold of dorsal wall and it is called Typhlosole. This increase the effective area of absorption in the intestine. The alimentary canal opens to the exterior by a small rounded aperture that is known as anus. Ingested organic rich soil passes through the digestive tract where digestive enzymes break down complex food into smaller absorbable units. The simpler molecules, they are absorbed through intestinal membranes and are utilized. So this way, in the body of earthworm, well organized alimentary canal is located. Main regions, they are mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, gizzard, stomach, intestine, and at last anus. And through this alimentary canal, the digestion process in the body of earthworm is carried out. Now let's study nephridial system in the body of earthworm. This nephridia, they are organized in the body of earthworm. This nephridia is part of excretory system, or we can also say where excretory organ occur as segmentally arranged coiled tube structure is called nephridia. Its singular is nephridium. This figure we can study these three types of nephridia located in the body of earthworm. So basically they are of three types: septal nephridia, which are present on both sides of the intersegmental septa of segment 15 to the last that open into intestine. So this is location of septal nephridia. Second, integumentary nephridia, they are attached to lining of the body wall of segment 3 to the last. One thing is important here, its location segment 3 to the last that open on the body surface. Third one, that is pharyngeal nephridia. This pharyngeal nephridia, they are present as a three paired crops in the 4, 5 and 6 number of segment, as you can see in this figure also easily. So this way, all three types of nephridia, it means pharyngeal, integumentary nephridia and septal nephridia present in the body of earthworm. These different types of nephridia are basically similar in structure. Nephridia, they regulate the volume and composition of the body fluids. A nephridium starts out as a funnel that collects excess fluid from coelomic chamber. The funnel connects with the tubular part of the nephridium, which delivers the waste through a pore to the surface in the body wall into the digestive system. So, well-organized excretory system, it means unit, nephridia are present in the body of this animal, and basically they are of three types: pharyngeal, integumentary and septal nephridia. Earthworm, its reproductive system. In the body of earthworm, well organized reproductive system is located. As you know, earthworm is a hermaphrodite animal. It means that bisexual. It means within one animal, both reproductive system, male and female, both are present. Or we can also say testes and ovaries, both are present in same individual, as you can see in this figure also. So this figure gives us clear idea about organization of male and female reproductive system within this animal body. Here there are two pairs of testes present in the segment number 10th and 11th. There was a differential run up to 18th segment where they join the prostatic duct. We can see here clearly in this figure also. Two pairs of accessory glands, they are present, one pair each in the segment 17 and 19. The common prostate and spermatic duct, that is vasa deferentia, opens to the exterior by a pair of male genital pore on the ventrolateral side of 18th number of segment. Four pair of spermatica are located in segment number 6, 7, 8, 9. It means that this four pairs occupied four segment. It's like 6, 7, 8 and 9. This organization is actually one pair in each segment. This figure gives clear idea about the organization of spermatica here. You can see here in this figure segment number 6, 7, 8, 9, each one is having one pair of spermatica. Their function, main role, they receive and store spermatozoa during copulation. In female reproductive system of this organism, earthworm, it is having one pair of ovaries which is attached at the intersegmental septum, and it is a segment number 12 and 13. Here also we can say in this figure clearly the segment number 12 and 13, it show location of this one pair of ovary in this animal. Further, ovarian funnels, they are present beneath the ovaries which continue into oviduct, then join together and open on the ventral side as a single median female genital pore on the 14th segment. So this way the body of this animal, female reproductive system, is also well organized. So here, as a part of male reproductive system, it is a testes, spermatica, then this type of structure, accessory ducts are observed. For female reproductive system, ovaries, oviduct, and this type of structure is observed as a female reproductive system in the body of earthworm. A mutual exchange of sperm occur between two worms during mating. One worm has to find another worm and they mate juxtaposing opposite gonadal opening, exchanging packets of sperm called spermatophore. It is interesting that this earthworm body, it possesses both system together as a male reproductive system and female reproductive system, but then fertilization process takes place by exchanging of this way. Mature sperm and excess and nutritive fluid are deposited in cocoons produced by the gland cells of clitellum. Fertilization and development occur within the cocoons which are deposited in soil. The ova or eggs, they are fertilized by the sperm cells within the cocoon, which then slips off and worm and is deposited in or on the soil. Cocoon holds the worm embryos. After about 3 weeks, each cocoon, it produces 2 to 20 baby worms with an average of 4. Development of earthworm is direct. It means that they do not show any larval stage during this development. So this way, in the body of earthworm, at the time of fertilization, actually a mutual exchange of sperm take place between two organisms, two worms, at the time of their mating period, and this organization, they are exchanging packets, and at that time position is juxtaposing opposite to gonadal opening to exchange this type of spermatophores. And fertilization process take place.